How'd you find me then?
Your mum told me. Apparently she got a call from a young lady that you've been spending some time with.
Natalie. We're not. No, it's not.
I didn't think it was. I suppose a part of me hoped that.
Oh, you hoped. You hoped that I was finally fucking someone living here.
No.
Yeah, you did.
God, you can twist things around, can't you? Poor Harding. The miserable, drunk little victim sitting at home. Honestly. I mean, I'm surprised that you're not even embarrassed by yourself at this point. It's pathetic. I was hoping that you'd maybe come away, you've moved on, started a clean slate, maybe. Move forward. Lanny gave me this. He's been trying to get through to you.
I am trying, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I am. I'm fucking trying.
Look at yourself.
Why do you think I came here? I came here in the first place to try and resolve my past so I can move forward. I am fucking trying. Maybe I need to try harder. I just don't think I'll ever move on, even if she has.
Has she?
She says so.
So you've talked to her?
Mostly been one-sided. She replied to the last message saying you should move on, as I have. I know you're gonna say I'm being irrational and I should just let go, but I genuinely cannot comprehend the thought of giving up on us. It doesn't make sense to me.
Maybe you don't have to. Maybe you can hold a space for her in your heart like I hold a space for your mum. Always. It doesn't mean that you can't go on to have other great loves and live a full life.
I don't know.
Well, take it from someone who does. It's easy to believe that our ability to love is finite, especially when your heart is broken. Believe it or not, slowly, you will heal. And your capacity for love will grow exponentially. You'll be able to keep a space for Tessa in your heart, for your family, for your future children, for anybody who comes into your life. And you never know, maybe you and Tessa are meant to be together. And if that is the case, then you will find your way back to each other. But it's not gonna happen like this, is it? Look at you. You go on drinking and messing up the way you are.
You're right. You are, of course you're right. You know, my life was finally getting somewhere. You know, with the book, I actually finally did something. Something I was proud of. And then, yeah, I mean, I guess it fucked up and everything blew up in my face, and now the bar's so fucking high, I'll never get back there again. I'm so scared of failing. So I just end up ruining everything instead. It's pathetic. You're right.
Listen to
me. It's fucking pathetic,
isn't
it? Listen.
You need to change the metrics by which you define success. You can start by writing one page a day. Just that, and that'll be your success. And if your second book comes out and it flunks, but you've been real and authentic, then that is a success. Whether you end up with the woman you have loved or not, you have loved with every cell in your being, and that in and of itself is a spectacular success.
Wow. You're not bad at this, that stuff.
Now that, for me, is the pinnacle of success.